In every culture, people have found symbolic sacred places where they can recognize the beauty, the enormity of the universe coming together as a focus.
Around the world, people of all beliefs protect their places of connection, rejuvenation, and spirituality. But some sacred sites have become an unholy battleground of land rights and religious dogma. In Ethiopia, sacred areas that are sanctuaries of biodiversity are under attack by a wave of religious fundamentalism. And in Peru, Andean potato farmers face cultural devastation from climate change.
Si es que se perdiera el glaciar, pues posiblemente no existiría vida.
Things are out of kilter, out of whack, all over. What indigenous people know is nature. And they're the very people who are suffering the most right now. And those people we have to protect, and we have to learn from them.
In the Gamo Highlands of Ethiopia, it's time to light the fire. Across the countryside, people are gathering in sacred groves and meadows for Maskala, the region's New Year's celebration. The fire brings renewal, giving power to the blessings and wishes for the coming year.
I see news of the busha, tiro yo tiso, tiro anjinga tiso, chayinga tiso, ita o tiro as chayiko gatiso. Tiro yo tri, hai sandi ches.
The debusha is a sacred meeting place for managing common resources and resolving disputes. All decisions are made by consensus. Located in the Horn of Africa, Ethiopia boasts high plateaus and fertile lowlands, abounding with cultural and biological diversity. many of the country's 80 ethnic groups have continued to follow their unique spiritual traditions, coexisting with the Ethiopian Orthodox Church since the 4th century. Five 5,000 feet above the Rift Valley, the people of the Gamo Highlands have maintained their own distinctive culture, tending a network of sacred natural sites. Their indigenous belief system, based on the celebration and renewal of fertility, is called Woga. Among its many rules governing the relationship between the natural and spiritual world, Woga calls for the protection of certain landscapes.
Traditionally, when you go to forest to cut trees, you have to ask elders, and they tell you what to cut. You don't cut every tree you get. Tradition protects lots of trees.
Community leaders called Halakas enforce Woga. They call on special priests called Makas to pray and perform ritual sacrifice.
It is quite elaborate. There are guardians responsible for each sacred site. For example, there will be a person responsible to maintain and keep the sacred tree. There is another person to maintain the sacred lane and the sacred stone. There are also sacred meadows.
On sacred grazing meadows called Kalo, any disturbance of the land is strictly forbidden. This Kalo was saved for Maskala. Its abundant grass means a feast for the cattle and a holiday for their herders.
After the meadow has acquired a sufficient amount of biomass, then the people will be allowed to graze in the meadow.
The Kalo opening during Maskala celebrates the crucial role grass plays in the cycle of life. Mako Wario is the spiritual guardian of Milo Mountain, another place held sacred for generations. Mako Wario's practice is the foundation of Woga and the heart of traditional spirituality, ritual sacrifice. But elders have seen a change in the community's relationship with the land. Eka Haraisa is the guardian of Nagasa, the sacred forest where he contacts the spirit world. For centuries, the Ethiopian Orthodox Church coexisted peacefully with indigenous practices like woga.
All over the country, there are peoples who are going to go to the Orthodox Church and still practicing their own cultural traditions.
But in the past 20 years, the Orthodox Church and growing numbers of Protestant converts have become more conservative. Now, both churches reject woga as superstition, or worse.
Irdu lemebilat emitarado aidelem. He le amilko emitarado bete kristanti kaumalej.
Because most of these practices are attached to some demon worship, personally, I'm against them. Because it holds people with fear, and what they're doing doesn't really help them. Many people are becoming Protestant. The Orthodox don't like that, and the traditionals don't like that. Most of these people are coming to the Protestant church because of modernism. There's the synthesizer, the choir, the preaching. That really attracts many people, and maybe they understand the real message of the gospel.
No one has felt these changes more than Mako Dogiso, caretaker of Muta Mountain.
Ethiopia Orthodox Tewahedo Bete Christian Bemoyayet, Yenya is a Kaba Bete Christian Yisaralin below, his Wamino Bete Christian Asseritual. Xavier Abete Christano Tesserro. Befit Balo Kibula Kibernoich Emero. Bete Christian, Atadin Atatafam, Atenecam, Atadin Tastabic Alech, Bazibo Kurchigriele. ያለ ቤተ ክርስቲያን መሰራቱ ከተሰራ በኋላ ህዝቡ አመልኮ ያካሄደ ያለ ተቃውሞ የሚያደርጉ ሰዎች አሉ። ያለ ማወቅ ነው ይህንን ግን እንዳይደረግ በማለት ትምርት እየተሰጠና ወደ ንሳ እየገቡ ይገኛሉ።
ታኒ ሄይ ወዞ ታስ ማንሪስ ግን ሄይ አጋኔስ ግን በቃ ወደረ ሄይ ጋርሰሙ ተግዘይሰን ወሳይስ
danne zikabaretto botazi batame fe boncho bita ai zarir wurasira fe na bakkan tawba naseba ta debita ta utrawo sanatin
we see diminishing role of the traditional believers in society. The reality is that they are vulnerable. They are losing ground, the traditional believers.
Now, traditionalists say the conflict has gone beyond threats to the land. Terenke Sanka is a medium known for her prophetic visions. Sanka's coffee ceremony is an ancient way to communicate with the spiritual world. People consult her to rectify past mistakes or look into the future.
ሃይ ወጋ አይቀናይስ ኔታዞ ሳቃላ ሹማግሌ ድረጅ አሪ አይሰናይስ ሃይሳቅ እሶ ካም ይሻጋርኪ ሄሳግ ሽታና ቢታ በድ አይሰናው ይክላ አማኔ ታና ሶይ ጫይስ ኢዛው ባቢታ ቢታውስ
አሁን ጦንቃይ የሆኑትንም ጦንቃይ